Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be going into another game with my friend Talix here. This is going to be for that YouTube series that I'm going to be popping up with more and more co-caster friends and family. Yeah, Talix, you're family.
We're brothers.
We're the Handsome Cast brothers.
That's right.
So we're going to be starting off this game today with Liquid Snoot and Millennium 4GG. So Talix, take it away with the introductions.
Sure. Spawning in the top right-hand corner as our red Zerg player playing for Team Liquid, we have Snoot. And in the bottom left-hand corner as our blue Terran player for Team Millennium here on Neoplanet S, we have 4GG.
Previously of KT roster.
Yeah, very, very experienced player. Even going all the way back to the days of Brood War, been playing professionally, I think, since like 2007.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's what's been for... well, at least that's when he started getting major accomplishments in terms of StarCraft. It's 2007, I believe.
Yeah, I mean, being part of KT roster in general, like, doesn't even matter if you actually won too much. It doesn't matter. You're part of KT roster.
Yeah, you're just like...
That's like being like, yeah, I went to college with Bill Clinton or something like that.
Yeah,
like,
I went to Harvard University of StarCraft.
It's just so prestigious, it doesn't even matter. And look at that, he's got those fancy new supply depots that are out now, which have all these little doohickeys and doodads. And now it's just been submerged, so we don't actually see that anymore.
We don't get to see that anymore. Now you guys get to just look at the old school skin from Wings of Liberty.
So TVZ nowadays, pretty interesting. We've been seeing a lot of different strategies, but for the most part we've been seeing just Marine Widowmine. What are your comments on Widowmines?
Well, in terms of, like, what I've been seeing in terms of TVZ these days, with those Widow Mines, you know, a lot of the Terrans are opting to keep them either in one of two fashions. One, they're going to be very, very offensive, put them in a medevac, get them behind the mineral lines, try to keep the drones, from mining. Or they just use them defensively, put them in their own mineral lines, and then just always be doing constant aggression with, you know, marine drops, especially now that, you know, those medevacs have that speed upgrade.
Mm-hmm.
Holy cow, are Terrans being very, very aggressive in this matchup.
Yeah, I mean, Terrans are just being absolutely all over the place. If we watched games like the previous SPL match of Flash versus Roro, where he pretty much relied heavily on nothing but Marines and Medivacs, and just a couple of Widowmines here and there just to keep a little bit of map control in the places that he wasn't watching, Terran really now have the ability to become like the supreme race by just microing ridiculously.
Yeah, especially when you can kind of, you know, manage like two or three drops at one time, you know, hitting the third, hitting the main, hitting the natural, and, you know, being able to at least constantly do your production. It's really hard for a lot of Zergs to try to find the answer to that these days, especially when it is very, very heavy bio.
Now, looking at 4GG's build so far, typically we would be seeing the double refinery go down as soon as he throws down that command center, but it seems like he's not opting to do that, instead going immediately for that very quick third base, trying to get his econ to be equal to or better than the Zerg's way before the Zerg is even, you know, able to detect that he's going for such a heavy econ. And
yeah,
that's going to sacrifice some of that map control early on, as because we see, you know, now the refineries are going down, now the Hellions are going to start coming out maybe 3 minutes later.
Yeah, it's something that I've noticed a lot of the Terrans doing these days. Now, knowing that the third command center that was put in the main isn't going to be flying off to another natural right away, what it's actually going to do is just going to make sure that the main and the natural are completely saturated. It's going to be used to drop mules and stuff, and it probably won't be moving out of the main for a couple of minutes after it's built, just so he can make sure that the production and the income that he's needing is going to be there right away.
Now, this is the really scary point here, is that Snoot went for the Roachborn.
Mm.
Didn't get speed.
Oh gosh, and he's on two. He's already got 400 minerals saved up, 200 gas.
Just
are we going to be seeing seven roaches?
Overlords? I think seven, maybe eight roaches coming out. There
five?
Goes five, maybe? Just five. Maybe he just wants to keep 4GG in his base. Oh wow, never mind.
Nine
roaches coming out here. Now, is 4GG going to be able to hold this off? He does have a very limited amount of units since he did go for that very quick third base. He does have the bunker out here as well.
Yeah, definitely. You know, just thinking about this, you know what 4GG needs right now? He needs the Great Torp upgrade with that Neo Steel frame.
Well, interestingly, you say that because we're going to be watching Great Torp after this match. But I
believe
TVZ.
Is he still, like, the only person ever who ever got, like, Neo Steel Frame on a professional setup or, like, a professional environment?
I do believe so. I don't believe anybody else really ever got it. I mean, I guess maybe it's got its uses, you know, when he used it, but I don't think anybody else has ever gotten it.
It definitely have its uses right now. I love that he split up the roaches so that 4GG wouldn't be able to see all the different roaches at the same time. But here we go. Two Hellions coming out. He sees one roach. Maybe he saw a couple of the other ones. He knows there's going to be a few there. And here come the roaches moving in. Oh, so many roaches.
If he can get it, he can kill it. Right past that bunker. They're not even going for any type of engagement on that bunker. They're going to go straight into the mineral line here. It's going to be a bit of a problem. There are no Widowmines on the way. The natural is under attack.
Some really great play there by Liquid Snoot, keeping 4GG away from that natural.
Meanwhile, Snoot does grab his third base. He's got his Terran completely walled in. There's nothing that 4GG is going to be able to do aggressively at this point.
Yeah, we're going to have to be seeing him going into that main. If you look at that main mineral line right now, 33 workers with 20 out of the 24 that he needs. A little bit oversaturated, but what are you going to do? You're not going to be sending those SUVs to the natural to play, you know, truth or dare with those roaches.
Yeah, those roaches are those kind of guys that, you know, when you play a friendly game of truth or dare, they're like, go hit somebody in the face you don't know.
Jump off the building. Jump off the roof. Don't worry, there's a lot of snow outside.
You said dare.
Yeah, so you entered into a legal binding verbal contract.
Now here comes those marauders starting to harass those roaches. They are incredibly outranging those roaches. They're going to be able to take them down slowly but surely. But until then, look at all the mining time that 4GG is losing. We can start to see the food supply difference. Now actually 4GG throws down his commander saying, nope, I'm ready. You're done here. You're getting out.
Yeah, it was actually a really great play because it does force the roaches to attack what's closest to it, so it messes up the mic ring there by Snoot. And there we go. See, it is all cleared up, so we're going to be seeing a lot of those SCVs getting transferred back over again.
The great migration of the SCV.
Yeah, but at the same time, it was a big hit there on 4GG's income. We see that 4GG, you know, did try to run some Hellions into the third base of Liquid Snoot. Liquid Snoot only really lost maybe like 5 or 6 lings there cleaning that up. It wasn't very bad engagement for him at all.
Didn't lose any workers at all. Here come a couple of those Widow Mines starting to come out here. He's going to be able to use those defensively. But, you know, 4GG's still not in an awful spot. He's got his double upgrades now coming underway. A +1/+1 stim just about to finish up, and now he's got those medevacs on reactor timings. Now, finally getting his double gas, though. So that's going to be incredibly late double gas, which is incredibly required for getting the medevac, reactor medevacs as well as double engineering upgrades.
Yeah, it does look like we're going to be seeing a drop coming out here from 4GG. As that one Zergling did run into 4GG's base there by Liquid Snoot, he was able to see it. And there we go. We get to know that Liquid Snoot knew that there are medevacs on the field and a bit of an army, but it looks like it's just going to the third right now just to make sure that he can expand safely. Oh, but Banelings.
15 Banelings on the way. The Widowmines are going to be used up on these Zerglings. The Widowmines then unburrow to try and save their shot, then burrow once again. Now here comes the Banelings, going to be doing some damage on the mineral line, and oh, they go around the command center, but don't actually get the shots off. Wow.
That was actually very, very good for 4GG. Sure, he lost a couple of...
killed!
That's crazy. I mean, he lost a couple of Marines, and he lost the bunker, but that's a happy trade to not lose, you know, like 20 SCVs right now.
Control S instead of... anyway.
No more sound for any of you guys
but
out there.
That's a lot of gas that Snoot spent on trying to take out 4GG's mineral line, and that's going to be delaying his technology a lot. We can see already only +2 carapace on the way, as well as +1 melee. +1 range hasn't come out or anything like that. Oh yeah, we have the upgrades tab. So yeah, looking at the upgrades tab, there's only +1 carapace coming out here. And 4GG's got way better upgrades coming out. I mean, he's already got +2/+2 underway. He's already got the stim, and he's got the medevacs, which, I mean, you don't even need upgrades for a medevac, you just need medevacs.
Yeah, and the combat shield as well, which is just fantastic.
Now, so he's going for that fourth base.
You know, it's a good place, but, you know, it's so close to the Terran. It's so far away by ground to get to it. You really need some amazing creep spread. You know, honestly, it almost seems like it would have been a better idea to take the base at the top of the map. Just because, you know, especially in Snoot's position, that he's already got creep spread, like, all the way up there. Actually, he's just going
to
do it anyway.
And look, he left little roach skittles to trace him to... It's like, you know, It's like, how do you get through and find my other base? Well, you just follow the roaches, and the roaches will lead you right to my base.
Yeah, exactly.
Now, I know those roaches are for scouting and, you know, making sure, but since there's two of them, and he's actually even running towards the other base instead of running back home or running into the army, this might be... Oh, he's going to scout this base, that's for sure. Snoot is making a response. He's got a couple of Banelings coming in, as well as Zergling, but he's definitely going to lose his base beforehand. And all of that, but the Marauders are positioned in the back on the ramp, so the Marauders are going to soak up the damage from those Banelings.
Yes, indeed. You can see, looks like actually quite a few Sporecrawlers going down here in like the bottom center. The top base falls as well. Some really great multi-pronged attacks there by Snoot, or by 4GG. And we can see that Snoot trying to do a little bit of counter-aggression here, but there's a lot of Marines as these SCVs try to get to that third base. And all the Zerglings get cleaned up by just a couple of Marines.
Yeah, that was really good defense from 4GG. I mean, he only lost five workers. Snoot only lost three, but he lost the base, and that's really what matters here. A couple of Banelings coming in here to make some hits, and it looks like 4GG is going to lose this army, but was that just a distraction? Because now there's also a drop in the main, but the main drop didn't do too much damage itself.
No, but as it is, that it did really kind of limit Snoot's ability to bring in some good income. Losing those two bases is a big loss. But here we go. Looks like he's doing a counterattack to 4GG here in the bottom base. And a lot of Zerglings actually in here, but it will get forced back now that the Widowmine's moving forward. Quite a few Widowmines, actually five of them. As well as the Marines and Medivacs, keeps that base alive for now. And there's, of course, the base in the top left-hand corner, 4-4-GG as well, with that Planetary Fortress. Doesn't really... Wow, that's
Glad we both saw that at the same exact time. Eight mules coming down immediately here, 4-4-GG. He's also got these nice three Marines over here to scout up at this top 12 o'clock base to see if that's going to be going down. And the Planetary Fortress is great, but it doesn't actually deal with the Mutalists that are now coming in here. I was going to mention that before, that 4GG did drop in the main, but didn't see that Snoot grabbed the Spire. Snoot quickly getting away before any of the middle lines are able to take out the middle of the block. But another counterattack at the third!
Constant aggression here. Lots of those SCVs are falling. The Zerglings just showing exactly what they're made of. And then at the same time, the Mutalist coming right back up to that fourth base, and it looks like he will take him out as one of the Widowmines does manage to blow one up and spew it across the map.
But here's the really scary part here. Look at that food supply count, 134 to 183, 4-4-GG. And the upgrades are completely tied. No upgrades are still going down for anybody except for plus one air weapons that did just finish up here. So they're tied on upgrades, but the food supply looking pretty bad for Snoot, especially for being a Zerg.
Yeah, and as you can see, 4GG moving across the map right now. Holy god, he's caught 15 Widowmines. Or, yeah, something along those lines. That's enough Widowmines, that's all that matters. And tons of Marines. How exactly is Liquid Snoot going to be dealing with this?
That is going to be quite a question. Now, 19 Banelings coming up.
That's one way.
Where are they? I love that you can just click on that nowadays. They are at the third base here for Snoot, but he's yet again losing another fourth base, but he's going to get refunded the 150 minerals for the queen that was building there, so that means, you know, thank God for small miracles.
Yeah, he can make, like, six Zerglings now.
And all it looks like he's not even using those Banelings to go attack the main army. He's going to go attack the reinforcements, and a whole bunch of Widowmines are actually going to go down here and take out the third base yet again.
Oh, those Widowmine hits on those Banelings sure did kill off a lot of the Widowmines, but now that there's like only a couple of Banelings left, actually, I'm just going to be streaming right across the map. Wow, good pickup there by 4GG as he blasts his Medivacs away, keeping them away from the Mutalists as much as possible. Wow, what a good hold there by Snoot.
Yeah, beautiful play here by Snoot. He forces the hand of 4GG to be either you go in your Medivacs or I kill your entire ground army. And if you go into your Medivacs, my Mutalists are now faster. And we're going to be able to catch up, buddy. We're not going to run away.
All right, a little bit of that counter-aggression. It looks like there's just attack after attack here from each player. That bottom base there, 4-4-GG, has been cleared up. We can see a couple of Banelings and Mutalists moving around the map right now, and that does seem to be a very common trait in what I've been seeing in ZVT these days. A lot of the Ling Bling Muta play, just to try to counteract a lot of the aggression the Terran has been doing with the Medivacs, because they're so versatile.
Oh, but the Banelings! Oh, I thought they were going to be a little bit more damage, but the Marines were caught off guard, as well as the Widowmines up the ground while they were pushing out from the natural. And a couple Baneling hits did do a little bit of damage there. Snoot still behind in the food supply count, trying to get up as many units as possible. Here comes another 17 Banelings. This is going to be a very close battle here.
Oh, he's going to have to hit those Banelings as they're morphing. Let's see how many he can get. One, two, three.
Wow, cancels. Those are cancels.
That is sick.
That is some amazing micro there coming out.
That was crazy. All right, well, it just looks like it's almost like a base race at this point. Very, very even supplies. Each player, you know, basically attacking with whatever they can right now. But, you know, with the fact that Snoot has these Banelings... Oh, and some amazing hits on 4GG's army. That was really, really sick.
And he's getting more Banelings up, but until then, he's going to be losing yet another base. But that's okay. He has taken out the natural and the third... Well, most of the third base here. 4GG. 4-4-GG.
Well, yeah.
4-4-4-GG.
And on top of that, Snoot has that gold mineral expansion in the center as well.
As long as Snoot can win here, there's so many minions coming in, they're all going to get picked up, but here comes the Mutalisk. Aren't they going to be able to pick off any of those medevacs? One does go down. Here comes another one, but a whole bunch of Marines are coming out here. Oh, and Snoot has to pull back last second as the Marines were just too split. And the gold base up here for Snoot. Oh, man. I can't handle this.
If that falls, then there's no income left for Snoot.
I can't handle this. Oh, and here comes the Bailey coming up from behind, but there is a really good spread out here from 4GG, and it looks like 4GG is going to lose a lot of his Marines, but not enough to stop this gold base from going down. One more Mutalisk flies in. There's the GG Snoot GGs. Wow, I'm getting some modest replay contributions here.
That was actually good games.
I asked for good games, and people aren't submitting things where they just won. They submit actually good games.
Yeah, that was actually a very, very fantastic game. It basically came down to a base race. Both players on very, very low, you know, army supply. Their income was basically non-existent. The reason why 4GG got the win on that one was that he had his third base just barely mining, and Snoot only had that gold base, and as it was going to fall, he had no income left. So 4GG could actually make more Marines.
They were both down to below 40 harvesters by the 23-minute mark, 38 to 24. But 4GG, Mule's too OP.
Mule's pretty good, man.
Mule's pretty good. All right, so let's get out of this replay. We'll take another little short break here, and then we'll get into game number 3, a Giant Smurf versus Greetorp.